waited for this evening, Psalm 65. Thou, O God, art praised in Zion, and unto thee shalt thou be performed in Jerusalem. Thou that hearest the prayer, unto thee shall all flesh come. My misdeeds prevail against me. O be thou merciful unto us. Blessed is the man whom thou choosest and receivest unto him. He shall dwell in thy court, and shall be satisfied with the pleasures of thy house, even of thy holy temple. Thou shalt show us wonderful things in thy righteousness, O God of our salvation. Thou that art the hope of all the ends of the earth, and of them that remain in the broad sea, who in his strength setteth fast the mountains, and is girded about with power, who stilleth the raging of the sea, and the noise of his waves, and the madness of the wind. They also that dwell in the uttermost parts of the earth shall be afraid of thy token. Thou that makest the outgoings of the morning and evening to praise them. Thou visitest the earth and blessest it. Thou makest it very plenteous. The river of God is full of water. Thou preparest their corn, for so thou providest for thee. Thou waterest her furrows, thou sendest rain into the little valleys thereof. Thou makest it soft with the drops of rain, and blessest the increase of it. Thou crownest the year with thy goodness, and the clouds drop down. They shall drop unto the dwellings of the wilderness, and the little hills shall rejoice on every side. Folds shall be full of sheep. The valleys also shall stand so thick with corn that they shall laugh and sing. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
In the day the Lord God made the earth and the heavens, when no plant of the field was yet in the earth, and no herb of the field had yet sprung, for the Lord God had not yet caused it to rain upon the earth, and there was no water on the ground. But a stream would rise from the earth, and water the whole face of the ground. Then the Lord God formed man from the dust of the ground, and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and the man came a living being. And the Lord God planted a garden in Eden in the east, and there he put the man he had formed. Out of the ground the Lord God made to grow every tree which is pleasant to the sight and good for food. The tree of life also in the midst of the garden, and the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. A river flows out of Eden to water the garden, and from there it divides and becomes four branches. The name of the first is Pishon. It is the one that flows around the whole land of Canaan, where there is gold. And the gold of that land is good. Delia and onyx stone are wonderful. The name of the second river is Kishon. It is the one that flows around the whole land of Cush. The name of the third river is Tigris, which flows east of Assyria. And the fourth river is the Euphrates. The Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to till it and keep. And the Lord God commanded the man, you may freely eat of every tree of the garden, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat, for in the day
hath shod strength with his arm. He hath scattered the proud in the imagination of their heart. He hath put down the mighty from their seat, and hath exalted the humble and meek. He hath filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he hath sent empty away. He remembering his mercy hath spoken his servant Israel, as he promised to our forefathers, Abraham and his seed forever. Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Second lesson, the Gospel according to St. Luke, with the eighth chapter, beginning at the 22nd verse. One day, he got into a boat with his disciples, and they said to him, "Let us go across to the other side of the lake." So they put out, and while they were sailing, he fell asleep. Again, swept down on the lake, and the boat was filling with water, and they were in danger. They went to him and woke him up, shouting, "Master, Master, we are perishing." And he woke and rebuked the wind and the raging waves. They ceased, and there was a calm. And he said to them, "Where is your faith?" They were afraid and amazed, and said to one another, "Who then is this, that he commands even the winds and the water, and they obey?" Then they arrived at the country of the Gerasenes, which is opposite Galilee. As he stepped out on land, a man of the city who had demons met him. For a long time he had borne no clothes, and did not live in a house, but amongst the tombs. When he saw Jesus, he fell down before him and shouted at the top of his voice, "What have you to do with me, Jesus, Son of the Most High God? I beg you, do not torment me." For Jesus had commanded the unclean spirit to come out of him. For many times it had seized him. He was kept in the guard and bound with chains and shackles, but he would break the bonds and be driven by the demon into the wild. Jesus then asked him, "What is your name?" He said, "Legion," for many demons had entered. They begged him not to order them to go back to the abyss. Now, there on the hillside, a large herd of swine was feeding, and the demons begged Jesus to let them enter these. So he gave permission. Then the demons came out of the man and entered the swine, and the herd rushed down the steep bank into the lake and was drowned. When the swineherds saw what had happened, they ran off and told it in the city and in the country. Then the people came out to see what had happened, and when they came to Jesus, they found the man from whom the demons had gone sitting at the feet of Jesus, clothed and in his right hand. And they were afraid. Here are the second lesson.
Let us pray. Within the life of the Church, we continue in our prayers for the Deanery of Bourbon. Thanks for this patch of holy ground, for all that has been in the past, and we pray your blessing on all that will be in the future. We pray for the wider world, all who take responsibility for government at national and local level. We pray for the communities in which we are sent, and for your blessing upon them, for our families and friends, our neighbours and colleagues, for this community of Carshalton, giving thanks for the ways in which our lives are bound together. We pray your blessing upon those in need. We pray for those who will spend the coming night sleeping rough on the streets of this and other cities. For those whose lives are scarred by mental anguish. For those who live with the effects of COVID-19. And we pray by name for Roy, Sam, Minnie, Maggie, young Alan. Give thanks for all who have walked with us the way of faith and who are now at rest. For the recently departed, including Captain Sir Tom Hall, Rohan Smith, Aidan Lowe, and all whose anniversary falls at about this time, including Eric Park. We pray finally your blessing upon ourselves this night, that we may know rest and recreation, that you will bring us safe to the start of a new day. These and all of our prayers we make in the name of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with thy spirit. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God.